Hello everyone and welcome to another episode of the Forest Podcast. Today I am joined with Zubeida Tash. She is Education ESA Advisor. And if you are a high school student or university student and you want to apply in universities in the US, you may want to stick around. So let's get to it. Hello Zubeida Tash, I'm very glad that you are here. Thank you so much for coming and I look forward so you can speak to the Algerian youth about Education ESA and a lot of things.
Thank you Yassine, thank you for having me. My name is Zubeida Tash and I'm the Education USA Advisor at Word Learning Algeria.
Good.
And Education USA is a network of advising centers all over the world. There's more than 425 advising centers around the world, and we have one here in Algeria. And our main job is to help orient the students and help them get to their goal to go study in the US. So we work with high school students, university students.
All types of students.
Yeah. Sometimes recent graduates that want to go back to school. So our job is to do advising and, help them with the process.
Good. So I think it's the season where a lot of baccalaureate students who get their BAC or also the one that get their bachelor degrees or master degrees who are thinking to apply to study abroad. So I think, could you please tell us more about this center and how can the Education ESA Center help them to achieve those goals?
Absolutely. So definitely. So for everyone who got the baccalaureate exam, congratulations. This is an exciting time.
Yes.
I hope that if you're interested in studying in the US, then definitely come by our center. Well, now it's kind of closed, so we do all of our advising online, so everything is virtual. You can just book an appointment on our Facebook page, on Education USA Algeria Facebook page.
Good.
And you get to talk to me, the advisor. What we do is that we try to start from the beginning. So if you are in the process of you still don't know where to start, usually a good thing is to research your options, look what's out there in terms of universities. We try to find, the advice here that we gave is that don't try to match a university that might not be a good match for you, but try to find something that is, that is a good fit for you. So we understand that there's a lot of options in the US. There's a lot of universities, a lot of programs. So that could be a stage that is overwhelming. So our job is to give you the resources, help you kind of define your priorities so that you can narrow down your options and kind of decide on a few options that you want to apply to.
Good. So if you can help me just highlight these steps, or let's say a student journey starting from contacting you until the end. He's at the university in the US, hopefully. So just what are the steps?
Well, we like to call it the five-step model with Education USA. So the first step is to research your options, as I just mentioned. The second step would be to start thinking about the financial part. We understand that, university in the US can be costly, quite expensive, especially for international students and especially for Algerians. So our job is to kind of help you find financial aid, financial assistance, but also kind of help you create a plan on how you're going to afford your studies there. We try to make it a little bit more affordable.
Good.
help you at least find resources to do so.
Yeah.
And then the third part would be to start, completing your application. So that might require that you get recommendation letters from your teachers, maybe start working on your essays, all these
paperwork.
The documents. And we're here to help you kind of understand the documents that you don't know what they are and how to provide them. We also provide feedback on your essays and
Good.
All that. So we're here to assist throughout every part of the process. And then that would be after that, once you have, been admitted, hopefully, we help you prepare for the visa interview. And hopefully afterwards we can, work on your pre-departure orientation, kind of help you with what to expect in being in the US and on a university campus.
Good. So could you please tell me, highlight the most common mistakes that students do, especially speaking of paperwork, applications, essays, and so on?
I wouldn't say mistake, but I would say first mistake is a belief. And I think it's that a lot of Algerian students think that it's impossible to go to a US university,
yeah.
and that it's such a far-fetched kind of dream, which isn't. We're here to help you make it more feasible and more possible. So I think that's the first belief that needs to go. And as long as you are working really hard, because it is a long way to go. Like, it's pretty laborious kind of work.
Yeah.
But it's not impossible, and we'll help to encourage you throughout. Another thing is to just focus on grades. It's not the only important aspect of your application, because US universities have a holistic view of your application. So yes, your grades matter, but also it's important to think about what you do as extracurricular activities, your essays, your recommendation letters. It's a lot of things that matter in your application.
Good. I know that you have already talked about how they can book advising session or something, but if you can please tell more about how can they apply?
Yeah, so definitely go on our Facebook page, Education USA Algeria, or
Good.
Maybe you can check our website, educationusa.state.gov. You can find our center there and reserve an appointment. So a virtual appointment for now where we can discuss your application process.
Good. If you have any last word for the Algerian youth and also the ones who are mainly the ones who are trying to study abroad.
Yeah, it's possible. it might seem impossible, but it's definitely possible. And we have testimony of a lot of students who have made it there. It's definitely a lot of work, so definitely put in the work, stay motivated, and ask for help. Don't just assume that there is no resources. Education USA is here to help.
And it's totally free.
Totally free,
yeah,
exactly.
Good. Thank you so much, Zubida, for joining today. Thank you so much for all the valuable information. And thank you for watching. See you next Wednesday at 7 p.m. with a new opportunity.